Hello, hello, Ben here with more mysterious space updates. I always have to say space just a little crazy, because it's space. I've started putting together a changelog just to keep track of changes, because that's what changelogs are for. It'll be more interesting once it's online somewhere for people to read. I thought of, I don't know, reading from it for you, but wow, isn't that boring? So let's not do that. Instead, let's play the game. Let me make a ship. It's orange, therefore carrot. Because I like fruits and vegetables. So the first change I can talk about is armor and shields and things. So I guess I was noticing through playing that I felt like I wasn't really threatened. Like, I would take a little bit of damage, my shields maybe would be mostly empty, but then I'd kill the enemies, and then I would just sit there, and my shield would come back, and then I would continue about, you know, going on my way, as if nothing had happened. And that seemed kind of lame. So what I've done is I've first of all, reduced shields. The power of shields globally is reduced. But I've also increased armor. All armors are better, and increased the player's hull. So the idea being that you should, you know, you have to be a little more careful, and you'll take some permanent damage. That means you have to be even more careful next time. Also, because you weren't taking any damage before, or I wasn't, I worry about skill level. We need more people playing and testing and giving feedback. But anyway, I wasn't taking any damage, so when I found those alien artifacts that restore your hull or armor, they were useless. Especially because you just pick up new armor. So even if you don't find one of those potions, you just find new armor and you ditch it for some new shiny armor. So I want you to go through armor quicker to make both of those things more useful. Also, I mentioned before that, you know, I'd take some damage from shields and then just sit and wait for my shields to come back. I feel like I've played games before where, you know, there's something, like you get some power up or something where all of a sudden now you have a little bit of health regeneration. And then in those games, whenever I'm in a safe area but low on health, I have to stand there forever. I'm like, well, I have health regeneration now, but it's really slow. And I know that if I just sit here for like half an hour, no harm will come to me and I'll be at full health. So therefore, why can't the game just give me full health? Why make me wait? That's just frustrating. So I didn't want to, you know, put players of this game into that sort of situation, so I also doubled the shield regeneration rate. So they're weaker, but they regenerate faster, and you have more armor. And we'll see how that, you know, overall affects gameplay. I think it's a little more interesting. It certainly is more dangerous. I start taking armor damage a lot more. But I've also been making the game harder in other ways, and you know, let's stop rambling on that title screen and play the game and see the new dangers, which hopefully I will find before too long. So I have removed the enemies that just went in rings. If you watched previous updates, you would have seen those red spiky dudes. They would just move in these kind of stationary rings. And now instead I have them kind of free floating, but they chase you. They do this lazy follow. Oh, I'm gonna get you, they say. I've done that. And the rings were just kind of boring, and you know, you just shot at them from a distance and didn't care. I mean, there's this exploding thing to worry about, but this is nice. They follow you more. I want more enemies that are a little more interesting. Also, a problem with, well, never mind. So anyway, so these are good. These are good. I have also added some swarming / flocking enemies. Ooh, let's get a crystal. As I think we can see here. So these guys don't specifically try to follow you. They just kind of follow each other. And I messed around with some flocking algorithms that I found online. Some of them just didn't work. I ended up doing a variation. You can see these guys move around kind of crazy. It works. Oh, they got separated. It is kind of fun if you ever encounter two separate groups of these black things. They might end up meeting and coalescing. We'll see if we can find that. Another change which happened while I was talking about all that, or which was demonstrated while I was talking about that, is the little fuel indicator, and this is 100% cosmetic, but when you pick up the fuel crystals, it used to be that this little indicator up here, the crystal was all white, and I made it now be the color. Each time you pick up a fuel, it's the color that the crystal was at the time you collected it. Did that make sense? They rotate through colors, through beautiful pastel colors, although that's not particularly pastel, but anyway, and at the moment you touch them, whatever color they were, that's just what I had up here. And again, it's 100% cosmetic. I just wanted it to be a little prettier, so which is good. Good, perfect timing. So this is a new hazard in the levels that are generated with the level, and it's these force fields. If I touch them, whoops, I'll get damaged. Touch. Oh my god, that guy super messed me up. Touching those is bad. Yeah, and they also block bullets and those little swarming enemies as well. And yeah, they're bad. Don't touch them. So just another environmental hazard. I think I talked about them. I know I talked about them in a previous demo. So the final thing I'd like to show off, but I worry isn't going to come up for me. Yeah, there's another four. Oh, that's a silly force field. is a new type of enemy, but they only occur starting on the third level. So if I can get through these quickly, I will show you. Just keep playing. But if not, then I don't know. Then maybe I'll quit and real quick edit the game to start, you know, place them all the time or something like that. Just so we can show them off. Oh, that's spiky and dangerous. Here's some of those guys. Those little swarming guys are really painless to move through. Certainly in early levels, they get a little meaner later on. There's another pointless force field. Cool. So I have all the things. Let's just get out of here before I'm destroyed. I have no armor, as mentioned. Think this blue alien artifact will restore my armor? No one knows what it did. I have no idea. But it certainly didn't restore my armor. Alright. Let's see if we can get through another level without dying, and then I can show you the new bombing enemies. So, while that's happening, though, I can talk about, I don't know, a general sort of thing. So the way the game is coded, enemies are equipped with weapons and shields and armor in exactly the same way that you are, and they behave in almost exactly the same way you do in regards to equipment. So these guys are a little different, the ones that explode. That's not based on any sort of weapon. But the guys that shoot in all four directions, they just have a four-way shooting weapon. And when I made that weapon, because I wanted that enemy type, that became a weapon available for players as well, because, you know, if he can equip it, so can you. Ooh, there was a force field there. So the new bombing enemy has a similar sort of story, and I saw another. I have accidentally survived some force fields. So there's the new, again, bombing enemy. He kind of tries to stay above you and drops bombs on you from above, and that is a new weapon that is available for players, so it's possible that you would pick that up. It would be a bad weapon to start with. You wouldn't want it as your only weapon, to dropping bullets below. But it's definitely good for those cases when you have those little tunnels, as I've had a few of before, and you've got a bunch of enemies below you, and you would just like to kill them. Look at that precision shooting. Finally got. Anyway, so I'll see if I can find them. They're really I just died. Okay, so let's, I'll go through the code and make it so they can appear anywhere. Where is... I'm looking for a thing. Do-do-do-do. Level like a monster spawner thing. Why? I don't even know how my own code is sorted. It's because folders are collapsed. Why are they collapsed? Alright, yeah, let's just make these appear from anywhere. I have made the monster names, as you can see, or enemy names. I want them to be alliterative, just because that's cute. And I've seen that in other games as well. And I've also been naming them, though, after star names, and specifically going right now for Arabic star names, just because, I mean, that a lot of the star names that we have today are Arabic names, because there was a lot of astronomy happened in ancient Middle East. So they've got crazy names like that. But anyway, I'll go on to other things too. When I'm bored of those, I'll find Greek names or Japanese, like Subaru. Subaru. So Subaru is the name of the Pleiades. It's the Japanese name of the Pleiades constellation, which I thought was... That kind of makes the car name more badass in my mind. It's like, oh, you know, well, I don't know. The fact that I think that constellations are badass says something about me. All right, so let's go ahead and see if we can find these bombing enemies. You're not one of them. You're certainly not one of them. There's a 1 in 3 chance, in theory. Well, 1 in 4. What wasn't represented there was these swarm guys, because they're not one enemy. Well, goodness, maybe I'll never be able to show you. No, they'll come up, they'll come up. Do-do-do-do. Get my mouse off of there. Come on. Where are you? I know they're in here somewhere. Wow, I'm really high up. The terrain is, you know, so the level, there he is. You gonna get above me and drop your horrible things? I just took a lot of shots. And they blink red when they get hit by accident. My intention, sorry, I was getting distracted by bullets there. My intention was that they would turn red when they're dropping their bombs, just as another, I don't know, a little animation, and they should turn white when they get hit, like everything else. But right now that's not happening. They're turning red when they get hit. So anyway, now you've seen everything. And again, that same weapon that they have, where they drop five bombs, you can get it too. And it behaves in a completely different way from the existing weapons, which I kind of like, because I think more weapons is more interesting. At the moment you press fire, you begin a sequence of dropping five bombs. Five bullets, I guess, really. They're not any different. They don't explode differently or anything. They're just bullets. But I think of them as bombers. So, but anyway, so you press shift or A on the gamepad. It drops five bombs, and then you're waiting for the reload, and it takes a while. The reload is longer, but they also deal more damage. So it's, again, it's a weird kind of utility item. I think it's a good complement to a forward, you know, left-right shooting item, but you definitely wouldn't want it instead. And I'm trying to think of more weapons as well. I've also made EMP weapons, which I don't think we have encountered, and I need to work on them anyway. I need some new animation, but when you're hit by an EMP weapon, your speed is reduced, it's halved, and it works on enemies too, because again, they follow many of the same rules as you do. You know, to programming speak, you and the enemies are derived from the same base class, where most of the logic is handled. So anyway, and which also means we can make enemies invincible like you can be, or we could scramble their sensors, but that doesn't have any effect on them. So anyway, yeah, all those same like potion effects that happen to you, or alien artifact effects that happen to you could also happen to them. But anyway, so EMP weapons will be cool. I just don't have some graphics associated with them, because when you get hit, they won't make your screen shake. It's going to be weird. I need some like static effect to go on your ship or on theirs so that you know what's going on. But anyway, I didn't find any of them to demo, and it's still in progress anyway. So I'm going to shut up now. I'm done rambling. I only want to add that I will hopefully have another download out by the end of this weekend, you know, sometime Sunday or Monday, and then everyone can play a new Mysterious Space version 0.2.1. And I'm also going to try and put together a more, like a YouTube page that focused on Mysterious Space, where I post stuff so that there is a place to go to find these things. But I haven't really messed with YouTube that deeply before. I mostly use it to watch videos, so I'll have to learn how to do all that. But I mean, I'm sure they make it, you know, plenty easy. It's not something that's going to be hard. So anyway, thank you again for watching, and I guess goodbye for now, until a couple days. I don't know how to end these videos. I don't know what I'm doing.